Once you've got a steady supply of lead ingots to work with, casting your own bullets becomes a simple way to shoot more for less by reducing the cost of your ammunition. Let's start off by taking a look at some of the tools and equipment that you'll need to get casting. It's important to select a sheltered, well-ventilated location to work from, preferably outdoors. This will help reduce your exposure to lead dust and fumes. Equally important is choosing a sturdy, flat, heat-resistant surface to work from. As you can see here, I use a simple setup consisting of a couple of metal sawhorses with some old metal shelving as a table surface. Whatever you use should be stable and able to hold 20 or more pounds as lead adds up quickly. Next, you'll need some kind of melting pot. I use a bottom pour lead production pot, as they're cheap, reliable, and hold a good amount of lead. You'll also want to have one or more molds ready to go. We've also got a stainless steel spoon, nothing fancy, just an ordinary spoon. This is for skimming the dirt and impurities off the top of the lead as it melts, as well as stirring it to keep it properly alloyed when we flux the pot. To go with our spoon, we have some paraffin wax. A cheap dollar store candle works just fine for this. While we already covered safety equipment in our previous video on smelting wheel weights into ingots, just to review, I'll be using a good thick pair of leather gloves and an industrial mask specifically designed to filter out lead dust and fumes. Now that we've reviewed our equipment, let's get started. Set the pot to high and add some lead ingots. Depending on weather conditions, it could take as much as 20 to 30 minutes to get the melt going. If you're using a portable setup as I do, this is also a great time to check everything is stable, as nothing ruins a day faster than 10 pounds of molten lead in the crotch. Using a spoon, stir the melt as necessary and skim off any dirt or junk that floats to the surface. Place the mold you'll be using on top of the pot to start heating it. The more evenly heated a mold is, the sooner it'll start turning out good quality bullets. Next, we're going to flux the pot. We do this firstly to keep the alloys in the melt from separating, and secondly to keep the lead clean so that it's consistent. Break off a small piece of wax from the candle and add it to the mix. Give it a moment to melt and begin stirring with a spoon. Notice how wherever the wax goes, the lead takes on an almost mirror-like appearance. This is because the wax is preventing the oxygen in the air from mixing with the lead and oxidizing it. While the wax melts, it will likely smoke quite a bit. This is perfectly normal and not something you should be worried about. Once the pot has been stirred, simply use the spoon to skim off the dross and discard it as necessary. Fluxing the pot is more art than science, so there's really no rule of thumb as to how often you should do it. Just keep an eye on the melt, and whenever it starts to look dirty, flux. With the melt fluxed, it's time to start casting. The mold you see here is a Lee Precision 6-cavity made from aluminum. We're going to fill each cavity in the mold to overflowing. This is an important step as it ensures that every bullet will fill out completely. Don't worry too much about wasting lead, as any of the sprues we have left over are just going to get cut off and go right back into the pot anyways. Wait until the sprues turn from a mirrored silver color to sort of a dull gray, indicating that they've hardened enough to drop. Now we're going to grab the sprue plate handle and cut the sprues loose, freeing the bullets. You should note as well, most molds won't have a sprue plate handle. For those, they'll have an extended piece of metal that we simply strike using a piece of wood, and that will cut the sprues off for us. With the sprues cut, we can now drop our bullets into a bucket of water to quench them. Quenching is a process that will help harden your bullets more than just simple air cooling. The harder the bullet, the less lead residue it will leave in your gun barrel. While not always necessary, I do certainly recommend it for anyone who's using pure lead or wheel weights. If you choose to quench your bullets, make sure the bucket is far enough away from your melting pot that water cannot reach it, or you're in for a nasty surprise. Don't worry too much about inspecting your bullets as you work. Mold temperature is the single most important factor to getting a quality bullet, and depending on the material of the mold that you're working with, as well as the type of bullet that you're casting, it can take as long as 20 minutes to half an hour before you get to the point where you're starting to see good, consistent bullets with every drop. Be patient, and try to set aside a couple hours to work in so that when you do finally hit your stride, you can take full advantage of it.